Oracle's Exadata Cloud Service is in huge demand, and every Oracle DBA and Apps DBA must learn Exadata Cloud Service. That's running Exadata on cloud. In this video, I'm going to cover high-level overview of Exadata Cloud Service for beginners. Welcome to episode 18 of weekly video series with me, Atul Kumar, from Team K21 Academy, where we help you in your journey to Oracle Cloud. This is the first video on a multi-part video series on Exadata Cloud Service, where I'll share short, bite-sized weekly videos on a weekly basis to kickstart your journey on Oracle Exadata Cloud Service. So let's first begin with high-level overview of Exadata Cloud Service. So this is the overall components of Exadata Cloud Service, consisting of an Exadata Cloud Service instance. And this is where you have the Oracle database servers. That's 2, 4, or 8 nodes with storage servers interconnected with InfiniBand. More on this in my next video. Then you have this control plane, where control plane is a browser-based self-service user interface to manage the Exadata Cloud Service. You also get REST APIs to manage Exadata Cloud Service. Again, more on these REST APIs and control plane in the future videos. Then on the extreme right, you have Oracle Cloud Operations. This is for Oracle's team to manage Exadata hardware, storage, and firmware. Now, database systems for Exadata, you have DOM0 and DOM U, where DOM0 is fully managed by Oracle, where DOM U is fully managed by you as a customer, that is Exadata admins. More on these DOM U and DOM0 as well in the future episodes. Then at the bottom here, you see Oracle's storage cloud service, which is nothing but another cloud service from Oracle to store backup of your Exadata database. And the final component in this architecture, you see these clients, where client can be these applications that want to connect to the database, or you as an Exadata admins connecting to Exadata cloud service using either SSH port 22 or the database port 1521. Now, in order to connect, you have three options. One is via the internet, but for this internet, you have to expose your Exadata DB servers on public IP. Now, if you want to connect from on-premise using private IP, then you can have other options like VPN Connect and Fast Connect. So to do a quick recap, you have Exadata Cloud Service instance consisting of 2, 4, or 8 node database system with storage cell and InfiniBand network. Then you have a control plane, which is used for self-service user interface by you as an Exadata admin to manage Exadata Cloud Service. Then you have cloud operations that is being used by Oracle's team to manage the hardware, which is and firmware and DOM0 part of Exadata Cloud Service. Then you have object storage to take the backup of Exadata Cloud Service. Then you have a clients that can connect over the public internet interface or using private IP via VPN Connect or Fast Connect. Well, that was high level overview of Oracle's Exadata Cloud Service. Now in the next video, I'm going to talk about architecture of this Exadata DB servers, covering the database servers, Exadata storage servers, InfiniBand network, management console, and three different type of networks, and where are these used. So if you want to be notified when I release the next video, then don't forget to subscribe to an email notification by going to this URL k21academy.com/exadata-cs01. All you need to do is put your name, email address, and click on this button, yes, I'm interested. So when I release the next video, I'll send an email to you. And if you like this video, then don't forget to share it with your colleagues and DBA friends as we learn better in groups. I'll see you next week with architecture of Exadata Cloud Service covering database, storage servers, InfiniBand, and three different type of networks. So see you next week.